We all struggle and we all experience pain at some stage in our lives. And the thing is, it's inevitable. It's part and parcel of being human. However, oftentimes it's when we experience the deepest hurt in our life that we are presented with the greatest opportunity to open our hearts. And it sounds like a very straightforward thing, to stay open-hearted. However, most of us have built up a wall, surrounding our heart, trying to protect ourselves from the pain that other people potentially can inflict on us. And we tend to live in our thoughts. We tend to live in our minds. We put a lot of focus on mastering the mind, and I suppose a lot of the meditation practices, a lot of the mindfulness are very mind focused. It's about quietening the thoughts. However, that's only part of the puzzle. And if you're neglecting the emotional side of things, if you're not working on opening your heart, then you're missing out on so much. In fact, oftentimes when you come completely focus on creating self-awareness, but you don't do the emotional side of things, it can nearly become self-absorbed. All you do is self-reflect and self-reflect. However, the reason that you self-reflect, the reason that you create self-awareness is in order for you to connect and contribute to and with others, and to be able to build those relationships that are so wholesome and are ultimately what life is all about. I think we forget that part of it sometimes. We tend to be quite egocentric. We tend to want to do a lot of work on ourselves and understand ourselves, and that's all very commendable. But if you're doing that in an isolated manner, well, then ultimately you're still going to feel lonely. You're still going to feel disconnected, no matter how much self-knowledge you have. And it's about being able to crack open your heart. And the culture that we live in, and I suppose the way in which we live our lives currently, isn't really, I suppose, supportive of living an open-hearted life, because basically it demands that we're self-sufficient. It demands that we are, on top of our emotions, that we're always living a successful life, that we always kind of are just, I suppose, in control. And unfortunately, when it comes to the heart is full of openness and intuition. It has this wisdom about it. And I mean, you need to be able to tap into that. It's not something that you can control or, that you can dictate. It's this kind of innate guide that you have within you. And we have kind of severed our connection with that. We have, as I said, become very focused on the cognitive side of things, and to the cost of our ability to tap into our intuition, to tap into our innate desire to connect with other people at a very deep level, And it's about recognizing that, the whole journey of quieting down the mind, and creating a sense of stillness is so that you can open the heart, that you can reach out to others, that you can connect, and that you can find a way to contribute. And it's so true what they say. I mean, if you want to experience greater love, then you need to show love. If you want to experience forgiveness and compassion, then you need to show forgiveness and compassion. And if you want to experience peace, you need to create peace in the world around you. And I think oftentimes these are all things that we want, and we're so focused on them that we nearly forget about the fact that other people matter. We forget about creating that connection with other people. And I've been there myself. I mean, oftentimes I'm so focused on the kind of self-awareness journey that I just lock myself up with my books and, my meditation. And I suppose that's so counterproductive, because, as I said, the whole idea behind the work that you do in order to open yourself up is to allow others in. And when you've been hurt, or when you are hurting, that can be really difficult. But yet, our pain and our suffering and the wounds that we experience, they are what give us the capacity to crack our heart wide open if we just sit with them, rather than running from them for a lifetime, rather than trying to avoid dealing with them or deny that we're experiencing things a certain way. So the more we can, I suppose sit with our pain, sit with our struggles, and ask ourselves, okay, what is my heart telling me here? What is it that I need to do? What is it that is going to help me heal? And then do that, and then find the people who will facilitate that and who will accompany you on your journey and help you become that more evolved, open-hearted person. If you find you're shut off emotionally, if you really struggle with tapping into your heart and what it is that it's telling you to do, then I can help you open that chakra. Get in touch with me on my website. It is fundamentals.ie.